What's up, everybody? This is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley. It's Free Lesson Friday. Got something a little different this week. I'm turning the camera over to somebody else, my friend Corey Congilio. I asked him if he wanted to put a lesson together for Texas Blues Alley. Why did I do that? Well, number one, because I can 100% endorse his teaching ability. I can tell when somebody can teach, and I can tell when they enjoy doing it, and Corey has both of those things. Number two, he's one of those people that I talked about last week who currently splits his time between making courses and gigging. And with everything crazy that's happening in the world right now, not a whole lot of people playing gigs or going on tour. And so I'm using whatever platform I have here with Free Lesson Friday to shed a little light on the work that he's done. Right now, he's got over 15 different courses with TrueFire. If you like what you see here, use the link in the description of this video to go to his website where he has the courses listed. If you're going to buy them through that page, because the amount of money he makes per sale is significantly higher there than it is if you buy it on TrueFire's site. And I stress again, buy the course, don't join. He gets paid when you buy the course, not when you join. The other thing I wanted to recommend, check out his channel, because when he's not touring and he's not creating courses, he is making more frequent videos on YouTube. And as you'll tell by this lesson, they sound great because this guy knows tone. And if you enjoy the tone in this video, tune in next Tuesday for Tone Tuesday, where he's going to talk about these two fuzz pedals. That's all I have to say. Buy his courses, sub his YouTube. Now enjoy the lesson.
What's up, everybody? Corey Congilio here from Nashville, Tennessee, and I'm excited to share this little lesson today about how players like Gary Clark Jr. and Stevie Ray Vaughan and people like that over the years have gotten this sort of incredible percussive and aggressive attack, but still maintain accuracy on single strings. And a lot of folks will think it's coming from the left hand, but there's so much to do with the right hand that makes this technique particularly achievable and sound really, really cool. So one of the tunes I had to learn for a gig was Gary Clark Jr.'s Bright Lights, right? It's really fun, full of fuzz. I have a couple fuzz pedals here that we'll talk about also. One of them has a really cool story that I think you guys will really be into. So an online student of mine said, hey, I'd love to learn that approach and that style. How can we do it? So I sent him the video of me doing it. He practiced up, and he came back with something a little more that sounded like this. If we're playing maybe the Bright Lights, 3, 4. So we played it like that. It was a little too straight, and I said, no, the whole idea is to get this thing happening. So that's really the trick, is to kind of keep that 16th note motion happening. So if our tune is about here, our tempo, and our 16th notes are, it's important to kind of keep scratching that. And you can see how my left hand here is really covering up all of the strings. You know what I might advise you to do is to just kind of play through some notes in the A minor pentatonic scale that way. Maybe we'll start on this A, and we'll walk up to maybe the D. So if I went 2, 3, 4, so you're noticing what I'm doing is my thumb is wrapped around, it's covering up the bottom two strings, fifth and sixth, and then my other fingers are kind of covering 4 through 1. And that's how you can get that really cool sound, but you really got to work on it, so I wouldn't try putting the Gary Clark lick into motion right away. I would really try to play some scales, and maybe start on sort of the middle four strings. Maybe start on this D note. And you'll see how, as I play it, my fingers are always tucked behind one another, except for when I get to the sixth string. So slow it down a little bit. So let me play it slowly and I'll move it through some other scale positions as well. Again, keep your scratch going. Make sure that your hands is really muting those strings. When I come down on those higher strings, you can see that I really have to, this finger, this middle finger starts to extend and covers up the fourth and third strings. It kind of just does it by accident. Take a riff or a set of strings you're really comfortable with and try to just employ the 16th note muting first and then add the notes. Maybe try to do it at a bend. Slide. But the trick is all in the right hand. So that's a quick and dirty little lesson to get you kind of playing the guitar a little more aggressively. It's going to work for all of your Stevie Ray Vaughan, Texas Blues type players too. If you're going... All right, so when you're practicing this, you can use the backing track and take it really slowly and only add a few notes at a time. Let's try it. One, two, three.